Good morning, students. After a long break, today we are starting the new lesson. Lesson number 9, Motion and Types of Motion. As your exam is over, new year has started. I am wishing you all Happy New Year. Children, I hope you all may have read the lesson as you was knowing that next lesson we are starting or we will start will be the motion and types of motion. Very interesting lesson and very common that motion everyone know. We all are moving from one place to another. That is nothing but the motion and that we are going to study detail in this lesson. Okay, children? So you are expected to read this lesson today and write its new words too. Before starting the lesson, I wish to explain a quote, importance of struggle in life. Yes, struggle is very important in life. Where there is no struggle, there is no strength. Okay? So, just to face the situation is a struggle. If we have a power to face the struggle or if you try to face it, the obstacle that you find in your life that gives you the strength. Otherwise, if no obstacle is there, no struggle is there, you will not be strong enough. So, struggle is very important in life to be strong mentally and physically. Are you clear? Children, so be strong and for that try to face the struggle or the obstacles that are coming in your path. Now, come to the page number 65. Of your science textbook. I hope each one of you may have opened your textbook. So, lesson Motion and Types of Motion. If you observe the first picture of this lesson, you will find that one boy is kicking a ball. As the boy is applying the force by his leg, ball has moved certain distance. Second picture, you are observing that top is rotating. Someone has tied a thread around it and just thrown the top. Now, the top is rotating. In the third picture, you observed that a boy has thrown a ball upward. Ball has moved certain distance upward and now the ball is coming down. Fourth picture, a potter man is making pots, okay, by using the mud. In the fifth picture, you are observing that aeroplane is flying, okay. So what you had seen in all the picture? Only these are the examples given to you, but in our day-to-day life, whatever the activities we are observing, that activities are also nothing but they are showing the motion of the object. Here in all the five pictures, you may have observed that the object is moving from one place to another. That movement of the object from one place to another, it is called as the motion. What difference we are finding in all these five pictures? Yes. You are finding the difference in the motion of an object. In the first, when the boy has kicked the ball, you observed that ball has moved certain distance forward. Boy, and he, in the second picture, top is rotating round and round in one place only. In the third case, you observed that ball has moved certain distance upward and again it has come back. Okay. In the fourth picture, as wheel is there and potter is making the pot, wheel is moving round and round. In the fifth picture, aeroplane is moving forward, okay, in the sky. So you are observing certain difference in the motion of an object, means all the motions are not of the same type. You find that there are different types of motion, and accordingly today we are going to study the different types of motion, okay, as you had observed here. And some other examples you may be observing in your daily life, there also you observe the motion of an object moves, but in different ways. See here another picture. Okay. While waiting for a bus at a bus stop, other vehicles appears to be in a state of motion. Okay. It is a very common experience when we wait outside and someone is sitting inside the bus, you observe that person is in motion. But actually that person is not in motion. That person is also sitting in the place, but the vehicle is moving where that person is sitting. Okay. Herein in this picture you are observing that one girl is sitting. In the first picture you are observing that tree is in front of her. Okay. From the window it is in front, but in the second picture you are observing that tree is behind her, to her backside. Is the tree moving? Have you observed that plants move from one place to another? No. Plants cannot move from one place to another, though they show the movement. Okay. So, herein that girl is not moving, she is sitting, plant is not moving, tree is not moving, but the bus is moving in the forward direction, and that's why we find that trees are running in the backward direction. Okay. So, this is also a type of motion. If an object is seen by an observer to change its place continuously, then the object is said to be in motion. We say that in this case, the object is in motion if you find something is moving. That change of place of an object is nothing but it is the displacement. Keep in mind, children, very important scientific term, displacement. Change of place of an object is called displacement. An object in motion continuously undergoes the displacement. Any object, when we say that it is in motion, it is displaced from one place to another. It has moved from one place to another. Herein, see this picture, a train. Herein, this train is moving. People sitting inside the train, they are in resting position. But when they observe outside, or outer people, when they observe the people sitting inside, they feel that they are in motion. Okay. So, continuous displacement of an object is called the motion. What is motion? Continuous displacement of an object. If object is moving from one place to another, we say that it is a motion. Are you clear? Now, we will see the different types of motion. Okay. Types of motion are mainly of two types. One linear motion and another is the non-linear motion. Okay. Linear motion means motion where the object is moving in a straight line.